We launched in March of 2014, and I'll lead you through the launch schedule, but the boat is also coming for the market, and you may have clients for it, and a boat like this, the sales and marketing and discovery of a project like this needs to take place further ahead. It's not something we don't plan on showing the boat and having people run up and order them, so we need to prepare the work that comes with selling larger boats. I'll take you just quickly through the concept of the boat, which was the idea of being in the a super yacht style. So that was one of the phrases we wanted to use, was to be able to offer something really a step up from what we had. So obviously an extension of the Jeanneau yacht range. We could have chosen to do other things with the boat, but we wanted to really to capitalize on that range. And if you look today at the number of 54 DSs, 53s, and 57s, it's over 700 boats that are out there today. So that's a lot. So if you can imagine converting 5%, 3% of the clients that have 53s, 57s, and 54 DSs, which is a small amount, and as we saw this morning, that brand loyalty plays out even more on the larger size. If you only transfer a small percentage of those people towards this project, you already have a viability for a project of a larger boat. One of the key parts of the concept was to offer the level of comfort and the ease of use of a large motor yacht. So we got tired of saying, well, you know, if you want to be comfortable, you buy a motorboat, and if you want to be uncomfortable, you buy a sailboat. You obviously have to give up something to buy a sailboat. We wanted to take that out, and you'll see on both the outside and the inside how we worked on that. Create the step up, so I'll tell you as well as to not just the 57 bigger, but we really had to bring other things to the table. We wanted to design in customizable solutions, so we know clients this size are going to want a variety of different things. We're not really set up to build a semi-custom boat. It's not our job. People who do that very well, and that's not what we do. Our value added is in the design process. So the idea was to be able to design in a couple of different solutions to each particular part of the boat in order to use our industrial and design expertise to fit the boat to a variety of different needs. Maintain a pricing structure similar to the Jeanneau range. What that means is that we're not going to sell a boat that's an all-up price, which is what you see sometimes on boats of this size, that the boat might cost $3 million, but there's nothing on the option list. It has air conditioning, generator, et cetera. We're going to offer a boat that has a lot more equipment than the 57 on it, but not all the equipment right off the base right of the boat, to be able to, again, customize and sell the boat so it's based on the particular needs and program of the boat. And we also integrated a professional skipper in the design process who helped us do mainly systems layout, engine room layout, and the galley, so that we could have a both the touch of a professional that a professional might recognize, because again you get into the size where sometimes a professional is helping the decision making, but also so that people would understand a well-designed galley works for the non-professional as well. So the second concept was built around this idea of deck life, and you can see here the great spaces here. We have a huge flush deck here forward. You have a cockpit here, and in fact it always looks very strange because these two tables look actually very small. They are you're perfectly fine being five people around each one of these tables. So you have this seating area here. You have a second companionway going into the boat, which we'll see on the interior layout plans. We have a transom area similar to what you see on the 57 with the aft decks, the consoles, and the space here in front of the consoles for the winches. So you really have a lot of room throughout the cockpit. And you can see all of the sailing functions are led back here. So it really keeps the boat very clean. But a ton of space on the exterior of the boat, almost 50% of the length of the boat given over to lounging and relaxation. Exterior options include galley, grill, sink that are integrated into the boat. We have a tender handling system for the garage that will allow us to take up to a 285 Williams jet tender, so items that can weigh up to 500 or 600 pounds, which can't be used by the normal types of ways of getting things in and out of the boat. The transformable cockpit table, so what you see there on the inside can be transformed back and forth. The aft end, of course, has the sun deck like we have on the 57 today. We have a main sheet arch that we can have or not have depending on the way that the boat needs to be set up. So you can see here in the image, it's possible to have it without, with a fixed point in the cockpit. Obviously, it means that you have to have a different set of canvas to do that sort of thing, or you have an arch that integrates in with the canvas. And then you have a flush foredeck area for the front end of the boat, which gives it a sort of that super yacht look as well. Down below, we worked with a designer called Andrew Winch. Some of you may know him. He's a very high-end designer. It's the smallest boat that he's designed in 20 years. So 2 weeks ago, he was delivering in the same week a new 99-meter. For those of you who are non-metric, that's 320 feet. and a Airbus A340. So he does a lot also in the aviation market. So he comes from a very different world. He knows Philippe Briand very well, so they work very well together, which makes my job much easier. You don't have to spend the time arbitrating between the two, the interior designer and the exterior designer. But he's done a very nice layout, because what he's looking for is to create a lot of spaces you'll see throughout the boat that are very similar to what you see on very large yachts. And he kept a style that was a very clean style, where you add a lot of high-end detail. So you'll see some of the style here is a very simple style with a lot of leather handles, leather grips, stainless steel, and so forth. So something that you can see in the galley, for example, these leather handles here throughout. You have a big counter space area here, lots of counter space around, all household style. You have a regular Miele style dishwasher. You have a convection oven here, Miele convection oven. You have a full-sized fridge with freezer drawers. So it really fits much more into something that you would find at home. You have a tray here, which integrated into the galley return, which comes out, fits into the table, goes upstairs, and so forth. So there's a lot of these details of the usability of the boat. And you can see these hull ports throughout. They create just an incredible amount of light down below. Forward owner's cabin possibility. So one nice thing is this is the door coming in from the main saloon. So you have the ability to walk completely around the bed while the bed is faced the correct way, which is to sleep closer to the mast, closer to the center of gravity of the boat, and have a very long forward cabin with a full beam head forward of that space. And here again, you can see a lot of these leather details, stainless steel details, and so forth. So a very, very rich boat. And then a chart table area, which you can have or not have. You can imagine a boat like this. Chart table is, if you want an office, you put it in, but you don't necessarily need a chart table to run the boat, because it's all run from elsewhere. The third concept was this idea of the generosity of space. So we have the ability to do forward or owner's aft cabin. So I showed you the forward, but the aft cabin is a very similar layout. The idea of the VIP guest, and I'll show you that on the layout, because in fact, when working with our 700 owners of the boats, in fact, most of them were not looking for a large owner's cabin and two equal cabins. In fact, they were looking for a large owner's cabin and something akin to a second owner's cabin, but with the ability to have a third cabin when they needed extra space, because it's always a shame on a 64-foot boat once you're five people to be sleeping in the saloon. So it's there was really this idea that it's often a couple and they invite another couple, and that allows them that sort of flexibility. So a cabin that is a little bit higher end as one of the guest cabins. High-end galley with a large fridge capacity, laundry facilities, the idea of having a chart table and office, but you can have it or not. Some people are using the boat while they're still working and still needing to communicate with the world. And then all the head compartments have fully separate showers throughout the boat. And the idea of an engine room, which is a very nice space to create on the boat, and you'll see it in the layout plan. You give over a little bit of the space to the boat, but in terms of ease of use, maintenance, sound, vibration, everything. You really create a space, both inside that and for the rest of the people on board. It is fantastic. And then this idea of being engineered for choice. So the idea was to start from the very beginning with all the different things that we could do, the different things that the market was looking for. So we have two choices of interior design, for example, two different woods. I have here. I'll show them to you this afternoon and throughout the show. The layout choices, which are numerous. You can see already today on a 57, there's a variety of different choices. So we'll continue that. The different types of transom, so I'll show you that. That's a big option one way or the other, and could be markedly change the boat. We have the ability to lodge a skipper or a crew forward or aft on the boat, depending on what the people are using. And of course, all the optional equipment, anything from centralized vacuuming to air conditioning to all of those bits and pieces. Anything you can't leave the dock with. The transom choices, so you have a transom like a Jeanneau 57, so this one's not unfamiliar to most people. And then what we call a sport transom, which is where you continue on out the cockpit floor all the way to the transom, and that creates a very different look, a little bit of a sexier, a little bit more Mediterranean style look. But the market exists for both boats. When you analyze the market, you have a fair amount of the center cockpit ocean-going type vessels, and you have some more of the Grand Prix type boats, Swans, the Hunts and so forth. So we wanted to make sure that we didn't miss a market opportunity by not designing in something as simple as a transom area. In both cases, you have an opening garage. Obviously, the only difference on this one is the garage is not as high. So you can't take a jet tender or a rib with a console in it, but you could still put the same length boat inside it. On the interior of the boat, we do a standard interior, which is similar to what we have on the Jeanneau 53 and 57 today. So it's it's the safe choice that people know today as they move up to the line. We just have the teak, the apatik, which is varnished in the same way that we do the varnish today. And then the second choice was to do an oak, and the oak is done with what they call an open pour varnish, which is it's a hand varnished finish. And what that does is give you a very different feel. So instead of that sort of an almost plasticized type feel that you might get with the other one, you have a feel of the wood. When you look at it at an angle, you see the varnish that's dropped into the wood itself. So it gives you a very, very different look, and that done with a little bit of a darker floorboard. So I can show you the samples of all of that, but it gives it a very different look. On the interior, this is the owner's forward cabin layout. So with the cabin you saw earlier, here you have the big full beam head with a separate shower. Forward of that, you have the ability to have either a skipper cabin or a sail locker. On this boat, I've shown it with a chart table that's here with an entertainment center, but you can also have the sofa you saw in the images. And then you have here a lateral cabin, which can be a family suite. So you have you come in here and you have a cabin that has this VIP cabin along with its own head, or the chart table you saw in the images. So you can see by mixing and matching a variety of different things, the galley, the engine room here, and then the third guest cabin, which can be two separate berths that slide together. And you can see here that this cabin has an exit to the deck. So you have the ability to have, if you wanted to, in a more crude type situation, that area of the boat handed over to the crew. And then the boat sort of in the reverse, which is to have the big aft owner's cabin. Here again, the possibility of having either the chart table or this side cabin, but in this case, the side cabin is a completely closed cabin. You have a day head here, which can also be a workshop, which is kind of nice to be able to have a place where you can put all your chargers and vice grips and all that kind of thing. And then here, same chart table or sofa. And then forward, two identical cabins here, double cabins, each with their own toilet and shower, and the ability to walk through all the way to the forward end of the boat as well. On the construction side, infusion molded hull, sandwich construction, infusion molded inner structure with the aluminum subfloor like we have on a 57, and then we do an infusion molded deck. No deck liner, which means you have to dress the entire deck, which gives, of course, the boat a very high-end feel. It's 360-degree lamination of all the bulkheads, composite mast bulkhead, which is 3 inches thick, so it's a big structure, and then all the furniture is all glued together, so you have none of the... As the boat moves, you don't hear anything in the movement. So it's a very high end building technique, but that's what the market demands at that size range. And this is from last week. This is the infusion of the first hull. So at the end, all the boat will be. So there's no resin here and no resin here, but it's coming. You can see it's coming. It's coming. Go, go, go. So anyway. It's a big set of tooling for the boat.
Yeah.
And then I'll show you on the stand, because I'm going to run out of time as usual, but we have a fully interactive tool, because what I showed you there was just to show you a variety of different options. I won't go into the details of it, but what we have is an interactive tool, and as you click on the different things, you change the color of the boat, you change the transom, you change the interior layout, interior wood colors, the sofas, everything you can move around in the boat, you move around in the boat. So that's really the best way to discover the boat, and we can do that on the stand and so forth. And we do it with customers and so forth to show them all of that. And this will be an application that will be available for you.
And the standard rig is going to be?
So furling rig. So we wanted to keep with us in mast furling. Mm-hmm. So we keep it simple, because the idea is to sell the boat as a simple boat for a couple. But obviously we have all of the other options later on. On the 57, for example, we've done 27 different rigs. So it's we know that there'll be, and one of the things that the mast supplier has done for us here is that they'll do a full set of engineering plans per hull number. So if you want a spinnaker gear, or you want this, you want that, you want a second halyard, or you know, we'll do it. It's a spark craft, but they'll do it. But we'll be able to whatever the client wants in terms of options, we'll be able to build just that mast and give him a full set of engineering plans for just his mast. So,
will you be able to do a stern and bow thruster?
Stern and bow thruster. Yes.
And what's the draft?
The draft is 7.2.
Any shoulder draft?
That's the shoulder draft. It's 9.8 standard. The 64-foot boat. It's got to stick into the water a little bit.
Do you have anything shorting the arch?
I do.